am a poet. I am a monodramatist. I am an educator.
My name is Mudgu, and I am 8 years old. You know, I don't understand why my uncle Sam insists on holding my hands when I'm sleeping. And if I open up my eyes and look into his face, he tells me to shh, close your eyes, don't be shy, don't make no noise. 'Cause we don't want your mother to wake in the place. He says, don't tell nobody what is going on. I have a special love for you, your mother won't understand. Keep this between me and you. Last week he took his time and he climbed on top of me. Then he opened up his pants and he held down my hands. And all I feel is pain again and again. And all I feel is pain again and again. My granny used to say that in the olden day they used to put hot pepper in your... If you do it with a man and you are a little girl, you are in the wrong and you make it happen. And Granny never mentioned that in most nations, little girls are children of lesser gods. We suffer girls and boys to come unto him, and little girls and boys become toys to him. And my granny, speaking from a place of experience, couldn't circumvent the event. She was dependent on the economic presence of Uncle Sam, raping sons and daughters one by one.
And so the Sorplusi method, or the Sorplusi principles, are for me partly a gift that has been given to me by my mother, who started theorizing survival poetry and started looking at dub poetry in Jamaica and wondering how could theory around dub help the people to know themselves.
A lot of energy, passion, great storytelling, great performance.
She stripped it of like the normal elements you may see in theater.
The experience of seeing her on stage is everything that I think a performer should be.
She's giving you history, she's giving you her stories in a really powerful way, and I think it's really important for us to see her work because it's not just about Jamaica, it's about the world.
The Sankofa trilogy begins with the play Blood Clot, which follows the life of a 15-year-old girl called Mudgu Sankofa in Jamaica as she comes to terms with the fact that she's having her period and living with her grandmother, who is a traditionalist and who is very much ashamed of the blood.
Welcome to Jamrock, where I have to wash up the damn spot if I don't. Granny get heart attack, end up in a hospital with a bad doctor bill, but we don't have the money to buy no pill. Welcome. Yes, Granny. No, Granny, I'm not singing dancehall this early in the morning.
She's like a force of nature, you know, she genuinely is. She's so powerful in her own self and so powerful in the realities of women's lives that she brings to the stage.
One word, magical, because she just imagines things and then makes them come true. And when you think about the impact that she's had on our community, like her willingness never to give up and always to just believe in what everybody's doing.
The 8 Sorplusi principles, these considerations are self-knowledge, orality, rhythm, political content and context, language, urgency, sacredness, and integrity. And that might seem to be something very colossal, but when you break it down, we're looking at being accountable and being responsible. So self-knowledge deals with learning about yourself. Orality deals with communicating with people. Rhythm deals with identifying the cyclical ecosystem that we're a part of. Content and Context deals with asking yourself, am I talking about something that's important to me? And if I'm not talking about something that's important to me in my art, why am I talking about it? Language deals with identifying that sometimes there can be linguistic boundaries. How am I as an artist going to negotiate through that? Urgency deals with looking at what is happening in our world and actually trying to address it. Sacredness deals with remembering that ultimately, if life is not sacred, how can we then attempt to address the choices that we have made in the past that disrespects life? And finally, those seven principles culminate into this idea of integrity. Like, what does it mean to you to say you have integrity? Then I think we can engage in a dialogue of hope. That's what the principles are about. Self-knowledge, orality, rhythm, political content and context, language, urgency, sacredness, and integrity form an ecosystem of accountability and responsibility between me and you.